my city, where I'm from. Talking about change, well, I want some. Just a group of kids trying to get it on. But we gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. City on. We gon' be the ones to put the.
Welcome to the show. I am your host, Bryson Cool Cat Charlton. And we have here with me Alex Smith, Chad Deutsch, and my man, Nizzy Nice. Now, for all of you who don't know about the Hip Hop for the City here in Fort Wayne, this is our opportunity to bring it to you firsthand and let you know heads on what the project is all about. And I'm gonna go ahead and start it off with my man Alex Smith here.
Sure. Thanks now, for having us.
Nice to have you here,
yeah,
Alex.
Appreciate
to have
it.
All y'all here.
Appreciate
you know, are y'all doing all right? Everybody go okay?
Doing good.
All right. Alex, man, so why don't you go ahead and tell us about this whole Hip Hop for the City project?
Sure. Well, I'm Alex Smith, and I'm co-founder of an organization. That organization is called A Better Fort. A Better Fort is the organization that put this project together.
Okay.
We do all kinds of projects, but our main focus is to get young adults involved in the community, get them attached to the community, and with that, retain talent. We all know about the brain drains that happen here in Fort Wayne, people going off to Chicago,
mm-hmm.
people going to Indianapolis.
People trying to move to bigger sure. cities, trying to get to bigger sure. cities and everything.
Sure. But if we can do projects like this, Hip Hop for the City, get them yeah. involved in the community, we hope to retain as much talent as we can when they go off to college and find jobs.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So you said you do other projects too. What other projects do you guys have going on right now
sure.
over at the Better Fort?
Right now, we're still in the process of wrapping up this project.
Mm-hmm.
So this is our main focus, but come summertime, we're on the boards of Riverfest here in Fort Wayne, Three Rivers, Shindig's Soccer Festival, and several other larger festivals that are in town. And what we're doing is we're providing volunteers for those.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, what made all of you guys come together? What made it happen for you guys to say, you know what, let's do this for Fort Wayne. Let's go ahead and start this up. Like, who was the guy that just started it all off for the jump street
yeah.
for us?
I brought the idea to the Better Fort table, and I said, let's diversify our volunteers, and let's showcase the talent that we have in this city. I knew it was out there, it's just a matter of bringing them together. With that, a Better Fort approved, and then I went to Nizzy, who's part of an organization in town called Certified Music Group. And Nizzy was the consultant on how to find the artist, how to find the producer, so on and so forth, and kind of how the logistics of music work, because we're not a music-based organization.
Really? So mm-hmm. what else are you based on, too, besides just music?
Music, like I said, this is just one of our projects. So, like I said, we focus on getting people involved in the community philanthropically
okay.
through volunteer work.
Okay.
And Nizzy, he approved. He said, okay, let's do this. He was a little iffy. Eventually, he realized that this can be done once he saw the feedback from the artists.
Mm-hmm.
And then he consulted me and told me, you need to check out a couple producers, Jay Ray, Chad Deutsch, and it so happened that Chad Deutsch committed to the project and did a phenomenal job.
Now, Chad Deutsch, you are the producer of the actual My City video, right?
Actually the beat.
The beat.
Yeah, Kelly Lynch did the video. He did a great job with it. But I actually developed a concept for the music that you hear behind the voices.
Okay.
Not the lyrics, but the music. I also did the recording, mixing, and mastering of the
okay.
My City song.
Really? So, you know, getting in on this project, you know, how did it feel working with everybody on this project? You know, did it feel like?
I'm glad you asked. There was an incredible vibe at Digitrax that day. Digitrax is the name of the studio that we recorded the song at. It's where I work. Everybody just came together, and unlike some of the collaborative projects I've seen from some of the other cities, everybody was all in the studio simultaneously, and we had people just rapping and all the artists back to back to back, and there was a really just friendly competition going on between the artists. And at the end, I think, didn't we order pizza or something? And we
yeah.
all just hung out for
a
couple hours.
It was a little
hours.
Competition, but we settled it with pizza. Pizza settles everything. That's what, yeah, that's what
yeah, I mean, all the artists, and I give it to all the artists that were on the track, hands down, gave it their 100%. And I've worked with most of the artists, I think all but one, pretty regularly at Digitrax. And so I know that they really came with their best lyrics and best delivery for the song.
Okay, okay. Nizzy Nice. Nizzy Nice.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We have the certified man here himself.
Yeah.
So, you know, they said, you know, you was in charge of, you know, you knew the local artists too, and you yeah. know, so what made you know who you wanted to put in on this project with y'all?
Like Alex said, first when he came to me, I was kind of iffy about it because we have a label and we have a team, which is me, KP, and B King, which is three rappers in our group. So it's I already knew, group. You know, it was going to be like, okay, we can see what we're going to do about this. So I referred him to a couple people, check them out, see what, you know, if they want to do it. Like he said, J. Ray, Chad Deutsch, definitely amazing behind them beats. So we basically got together. And I told him that I already was kind of thinking about doing a song about the city, but I wasn't going to approach it the way he brought it to the table. And, you know, Certified was already trying to get involved with the community and trying to figure out a way. That's why, you know, when he came to me, it was like a perfect opportunity to hop on it. So that's kind of what gave me the green light, you know what I'm saying, to go ahead and make this happen. So got to DigiTracks, like you said, Chad Deutsch being a great producer, heard that beat. And it was just magic, like the hook just came out right on the spot. You know, it didn't take me just a day to listen to it. I sat down probably, 10, 20 minutes and just hummed that hook out, went in there and laid it down. It was just magic, so mm-hmm. it was a beautiful thing.
Absolutely.
Chad, how long have you been into the engineering? How long have you been doing engineering?
I'm on my 10th year of audio recording this year. Been playing classical piano since age 4. And I also play 4 other instruments on a semi-pro professional level.
Okay.
So.
What about you, Nizzy? How long have you been rapping?
I've been rapping for over a decade, so about 10, 13 years.
When was it when you knew that this was what you was going to pursue?
I was really into sports first.
What sport?
I was into basketball, track. It was like basically my 2 biggest sports I used to do. I tore my ACL 8th grade summer.
Ouch.
And you know, I just, you know, that kind of put me down a little bit. So I liked music too, and then I began to love it as I started, you know, finding artists that inspired me, and I just went at it full fledged. That's when I met KP too from freestyle battling, and you know, just being out there, I ran into him. Me and him got together, and then that's how we created Certified in 2007. So it's been a launch ever since then. So,
Alex, let me ask you, what is the one thing that just stood out about this whole project to you? The one thing that you just think that for the better for it and the whole Hip Hop for the City project. What was it that? What was the number one thing that stood out to you that you felt like, you know what, this is something special. This
sure.
is just
like Chad said, that day when everybody came into the studio to see their collaborative efforts,
mm-hmm.
To put down, you know, any beefs if they had any. I'm not saying they did, but artists don't tend to work like that collaboratively, especially here in Fort Wayne. I've heard that from all of the artists. So to see them come together in high spirits and just lay it down, become friends, and then to see now what it's become as far as a community attachment initiative. People see the song and they are starting to say, I love my community. Whereas the young adults before this project, you know, they would call it Fort Fun and kind of mock the city and say, there's nothing to do here, I want to get out.
Yeah, they was ready to go to the bigger city that we was talking about.
Yep.
And so that was the whole point of this project, saying, yeah, we don't need to go nowhere.
This
is our home, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of leave it, let's build it up. That's what I like about the whole project.
Oh, yeah.
You know, when I first seen the video, I first heard the songs and then heard about the organization and everything, you know, it was something that, you know, that opened my eyes, that showed, you know, this is some people who do care about our city and everything. Are y'all from the city? Are y'all from Fort Wayne? Born and raised?
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
Really? What high school?
Bishop Dwenger.
What high school?
Southside.
Fellow Arch.
I'm a Panther, so Snyder High.
Okay, so we're not going to talk to you. Anyways, yeah. So what about you, Chad? What, was that probably the same thing, like when you knew this was something special going on?
Absolutely. The whole thing, from start to finish just came together the way it was supposed to. No complaints. All the artists got along. The video, great. There was actually originally how many artists were?
Well, there's an extended version that has 20 artists on it.
20 artists. And they were all amazing.
Sure.
Every last one of them. So it was really tough to.
So about the artists now, have you worked with any of the artists before this project?
Yeah, I believe of the 9 on the radio version, I'd worked with 8 regularly, and of the 22, was it? They're on the extended version. I think I'd worked with 18 of 22.
Out of the people that you haven't worked with before, and after meeting them and getting to know them and hearing them lyrically and everything about that, who probably impressed you the most? Like that you had just met and everything like that. Like who probably impressed you the most? Just
out of the newer guys. Yeah. I liked Alibi's verse a lot. Alibi. Personally. Great lyrics. There was a guy on the track that, the one that didn't make it to Digitrax that day, that sent us his verse. What was his name?
I can't remember off top.
Well, there was, everybody was insane with it. We even had guys hearing about the project and what went on that day at Digitrax calling to come in and do verses after, the deadline had already ended, and we entertained that. We let them come in and do their verse,
Yeah, so that's for my next question. For the other artists who, like you said, missed the deadline and everything, is this still a good opportunity for other local artists to come out and seek help for you with you guys and to help with them and all of them get together and do something with them?
Absolutely. And the key here is the collaboration, in my opinion. The way Alex put everything together and brought everybody together to work as a team is what made it special. And it was definitely a difficult, task. It was, 8 months that Alex and I and the rest of the artists focused on completing goals. But I feel that a lot of different groups, I had guys calling me, why didn't I make the cut, this and that, or why didn't I even know that this happened? Do what we did. Get with your friends, find a video guy and shoot for it. Sure. It's totally, it's doable.
It's doable.
And what you got to understand is we didn't exclude people on this project.
Of course not.
We could only find those artists that were most visible within a time frame that we had. Mm-hmm. So if you were on Facebook, if you were on Twitter, if you were actively doing your job and promoting your music, we were able to find you and invite you to the studio.
Yeah, you get out of it how much you put into it.
Sure. Yeah, that's definitely a key component. That's like Alex said, that's one of the main reasons that he reached out to us, was because he said we was the most visible at the time. We was putting the work in, to get these kind of opportunities. People just think that you're gonna wake up and it's gonna happen. You got to really,
right there at the front
yeah,
door.
You gotta mm-hmm. you gotta put that work in. You grind hard, you shine hard. That's my motto. So.
And what's great about it now is I have a ton of people calling the phone saying, I want to do a collaboration with so-and-so. I want to do this and that. And I think we've set, the bar high for mm-hmm. quality here in Fort Wayne, Indiana, as far as audio and video is concerned.
Sure. Definitely.
You really did. I like to say that y'all did a good job with this.
Yeah.
I really find that this project is a good eye-opener for Fort Wayne.
Yeah, definitely.
It really is. And for the video, y'all had different shots at the video and, in different areas and mm-hmm. everywhere. So, some people might say, I heard a couple of people say, why ain't they do it down here? Or why ain't they mm-hmm. do it here? What made y'all choose these spots for the video? Y'all feel like these are the perfect mm-hmm. landmarks of Fort Wayne that we have here? Or
We sat down with Kelly Lynch, who owns a company. It's called Lynchman Creative. We brainstormed them all the different locations. In fact, I was in Sydney's Diner today, mm-hmm. and they saw the video, and they saw that Coney Island was in it.
Exactly.
And the idea is that there was limited amount of locations, and there's so much to showcase as far as what's beautiful in Fort Wayne that we had to select, the 5, 6, 7, or 8 that we selected. So it's not that we excluded any locations. It's that we came to the table, probably listed 15 to 20, and then narrowed it down based on, what's most visible and what fits in this video.
Okay, for Certify. So what's next? What's the next step for you guys?
Right now, we got signed to Sony BMG not too long ago.
Congratulations.
Appreciate that. We really just right now, we starting up a clothing line. Shout out to Mo Cheese and Grind Hard. We working with him.
Is it female clothing?
Yeah. He has Grind Hard for females and males. So yeah, it's both. We've been doing that, and we just really been like trying to hammer on getting our business stuff together and doing these shows. And we'll be performing at Little Fire this year with Kirk O'Bang. So that's gonna be on Wednesday, April 18th. So that's gonna be a nice little show for us. And we're just, you know, doing what we gotta do to, you know, put the city on. Mm-hmm.
City on. That's what we like to hear. That's what all this is about, putting the city on. Here with all these three amazing guys here, and that's definitely what I see the goal that you guys have, and y'all definitely accomplishing that goal. And I like to thank y'all for coming through and everything. Yeah. We're gonna meet with the artists next. So After this, stay tuned. We'll meet the artists of the My City video, which Certified will be part of, and all the other local artists. So stay tuned to that.
It's Nizzy.
This is my city, where I'm from. Talking about change, well, I want some. Just a group of kids trying to get it on. But we gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on.
I could be anywhere, but I'm right here. I'm living life right now, right now. I'm living life right now, right now.
Yo, do your homework, PMG represent. Folk Kane swag, what's the real testament? This is my city, south side to the death. When we put the city on, you gon' pay respect. It's all about the love, hatin' don't faze us. I bet everybody say the money changed us. But at the end of the day, you should embrace this. On life, you in the presence of greatness.
City on, we gon' put the city on. We livin' life to rep this to the death, this is home. Got the keys to it, had to get our ditty on. Forever catch us with that 10 cap fitted on. We get it on, and you can hear it in the song. United we stand, the plan is for us living strong. We had to come together, no we can't do this alone. Had to hit the ground running, so we set the tone.
If not my back, then why not yours? I went there first to open the doors and shed light on the city we glowing. Yeah, I'm repping for the Wayne, even though I'm from the go in, we go in. Even if the situation is a no-win, we stand strong, one circle of grown men. Here we go again, guess it's time to grind hard and help my city shine bright like the night stars.
This is my city, where I'm from. Talking about change, well, I want some. Just a group of kids trying to get it on. But we gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on.
I could be anywhere, but I'm right here. And I'm living life right now, right now. I'm living life right now, right now.
You know I gotta do it for the city. It's SB and got my certified team with me. Yeah. What up, Nizzy? What up? What up, K? What up? We tryna make a meal, like an entree. Yes. We out in NY, flights all day. Then we heading west, word to Kanye. Yeah. From the 266, where the best be. Who put the city out? Tell them SB.
I was born in Indiana, so listen when I say there's more than corn in Indiana. Made and raised in the 26 to be exact, so I feel that it's only right that I put my city on the map. If you a hooper, dancer, teacher, doctor, lawyer, or you rap, it don't matter what you do, stay persistent in pursuit. I'm the voice of the city, I gotta be undoubtedly. From Cherry Hill to Canterbury, down to Crown Colony.
Fresh from my head to toe, skills unremarkable. I am just a human being in the scene, writing flows, struggling. Want the world to hear my voice in a song, but war's going on in this world, we can't get along. It's been like that ever since a younger cat. Education falling back, blacks on blacks on blacks on black. Locked up for selling crack, government just sit back and laugh while they steady raising taxes on her. It's a fact. Ow.
This is my city, where I'm from. Talking about change, well I want some. Just a group of kids trying to get it on. But we gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on.
I could be anywhere, but I'm right here. And I'm living life right now, right now. I'm living life right now, right now.
Okay,
F is for the family frequency needed first, then O is for the organization to be dispersed, so all will represent that revolutionary verse. And T is for the team that we gon' need to make it work. So this ain't just a friendly me to popular artists. We ain't changing the lane, we gotta evolve it. Cause when you win the game, only option is balling, and your team can't win without positive yardage.
Yeah. I just put my city on like my jeans. Why these dudes throwing cheap shots? Mayweather, Ortiz, Chrome Hearts, cheese. You should come and see us, best in the game. You should MVP us, Fresh Prince Flow, no Bel Air, no Bel Air. Whoever's at the top just knows I'm walking up the stairs, and it's Fort Wayne to be miserable. And I'm Mr. Walk on Water Boy, James Miracle.
Yeah. City on, trying to run it like a marathon. I put it up and carry on, gotta take it home. Different walks of life, together going strong. And once we make it there, they all coming along. It's heavy repping, lucky stepping up in these sevens. Next election, I'm intercepting intersections. Touch the stars and inquire what I desire. Funny haters see my rich heart and want a piece of my prior. Yeah.
This is my city, where I'm from. Talking about change, but I want some. Just a group of kids trying to get it on. But we gon' be the ones to put the city on, city on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on, city on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on.
I can be anywhere, but I'm right here. And I'm living life right now, right now. I'm living life right now, right now.
Bryson Cool Cat Charlton, and now we are here with the local artists for the Hip Hop of the City, for the My City video. And I'm going to start off over here with Alex, and I'm going to have everybody introduce themselves.
I'm Alex Smith. I'm with the Better Fort, the organization that put this project together.
De Niro Moneybags put a dot at the end, jumped off the last verse.
I'm Troy Amos. I was actually the fifth verse.
KP. You can see what I'm repping, Certified. That was the second on the song.
I'm Nizzy Nice, Wish to Get Busy, Certified CEO. I wrote the hook to the song. I'm all throughout it, so here's what it is.
I'm Jamila, Chrome Cats, and I did the melodies on some of the verses.
I'm KJ, and together we're Chrome Cats, and I did the last verse.
And this is everybody who participated in the My City video. And let me start off by welcoming y'all welcome and everything.
It's a pleasure, it's a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
So, the My City video, everybody's seen it on YouTube, on the website, seen it and everything. Let me say, I was quite surprised of how good the video turned out. Let me say good job to everybody and all the other local artists who participated into making the video and putting on the tracks and everything. So, let me start off by asking you guys, so how did it feel coming together with all these artists in Fort Wayne and making this video? How did that make all y'all feel?
I started off, I guess. It was amazing to me, because kind of like what Nizzy was saying, man, you know, doing things for so long and doing music on a local level, especially in the place where we are geographically, you really just don't see the camaraderie, you don't see the support. You know, a lot of people usually look at each other like competition most of the time. So people don't take advantage of the talent that everybody has. Everybody just thinks that their talent is what it is, and I'm better than you. And So I think
everybody
that this kind of like set the bar for, first of all, we can come together, and second of all, we can make it super dope no hatred, just all about the love. And that's why it was so amazing, because it was really from the heart, you know.
Anybody else, how did y'all feel about coming together, making this video with all the other artists, Certified?
It was definitely a blessing, you know, just to kind of build on, you know, what he was saying. You don't really see people working together. I really think the biggest thing deep down for a lot of people that do the same thing that we're doing is that they want to be the first one to do something rather than just do it. And, you know, you're definitely going to need the help of everybody. You need the city, you need the whole state, because, you know, we're small in market size, so we got to compete with everybody.
On each one of y'all verses that y'all put in on the song, what was something that y'all was trying to put out in y'all verse that y'all really wanted to say if somebody else from another city heard your voice and everything on the track? What was something that y'all wanted to try to put out there to show, like, you know, the show about Fort Wayne, to tell them? What did y'all want to tell them about Fort Wayne that they needed to know?
Like, at the beginning of my verse, I say I was born in Indiana. So listen, when I say it's more than corn in Indiana. And I know a lot of people get a perception of, like, Indiana
as corn, we're
just making y'all, we are making y'all corn, don't forget right, that.
Right. Exactly, we ain't corny around here, people.
We still got that on deck now.
We go dumb. It's
a lot of hidden talent here. And it's just like, I guess this project for Fort Wayne was kind of like, I guess, kind of getting us out there more, like, to show, like, expose our talent, because a lot of talented artists around here. And I was excited to be on this track just because, you know, everybody came together finally, but I wanted to push that, like, it's more than Fort Wayne.
Right. Who was it that gave you guys the call? Like, you know, y'all heard about, how did y'all hear about the Better for the Hip Hop for the City project? How did you guys hear about it?
We heard about the project through, I believe it was an email, I believe, from Chad. Chad had told us about the project.
The producer.
Chad, the producer of the song. And we had went into the studio and we met with all the other artists, and then we just all collaborated on the song.
What about you, Miss Pretty Misses? What did you like about the video? What was it that did it change you somehow, just seeing all these different artists and everything? Did it move you in a certain way?
Yeah, I think it was really awesome how everyone could just come together and just make this really awesome project. And it's just really representing this whole city and all of that other stuff, and I think that it really has a really good message to it. And I was really amazed by how much respect every artist had for each other when we were in the studio, and I'm really happy about how the project came out.
Let me ask you, you was the only girl on the video. You was the only girl.
Yeah.
You was the only girl on the track. Well, how did you feel about that, being the only? Did you come in seeing all the dudes? Did you feel intimidated? Was you like, oh man, do you feel like you had to raise your level a little bit? You know, did you be like, you know, okay, I could take him. I could take him. You know? Like, how did you feel? Like, how did that feel being the only girl?
I'm just me, I guess. And
I'm just me. There it is. She just me. Yeah, she ain't stunting y'all. I'm just me.
I just really. I have respect for the artists, they have respect, and, you know, it's just really a group effort. It's not any one person that makes up the whole thing. It's a group effort, and I really think that it's really awesome.
That's good. So, Nizzy, nice, man. Just seeing everybody come together, you know, how did you feel seeing everybody doing everything,
I think it was definitely a blessing. And like I said in the interview I had before, I feel like God don't make no mistakes. It was just time for something like this to happen, you know. We talked to the mayor yesterday, and he was saying a lot of cities have problems with the youth coming together. And this is one thing that really caught his attention, you know.
Yeah, with us, younger people,
yeah,
you know,
with us, yeah, instead of, you know, crime in the news, or
exactly.
You know, it was
no, people not focused on it,
yeah,
look at the positives.
I think
exactly.
It put light on the city again, you know. It was definitely a good move, you know. I thank Alex for coming up with that situation. So
and to expound on that, I think one of the main things that really made it pop is the fact that we are all actually talented.
Yeah.
Like, I listened to every last person on the song. I listened to y'all stuff, you know, YouTube everybody once they gave us the list. And everybody's music is dope. Like, so it's not just the fact, it wasn't like forced, like trying to bring a bunch of local cats that's not really good together.
Mm-hmm.
It's like the best of the best of the best, even the ones that got cut. You know what I mean? So I feel like it's just the whole movement, and it's our time to do this. and the fact that we actually could, we actually had the talent to, you know, to actually stand up on what we were putting out there. Because, you know, we can't say we're the ones to put the city on. And, you know, you go Google De Niro Money Bags, you Google Chrome Cats or Certified, and it's garbage. You know what I mean? Like, people love us before this. So just bringing all of the loved artists together and the ones that do what they do, I feel like made it.
Yeah, I think when Alex, you know, with them being on the non-for-profit and having that organization, I think it gave all the artists a chance to be heard by a different demographic of people that usually wouldn't even have tuned in just because of the, you know, the stereotyping of a typical rapper or, you know, with the all heavy cussing and all that. But we just basically showed y'all that we can still make good music, you know.
Of course, yeah. You know, you don't got to use all the profanity. Exactly, you got to use all the negatives to make good music. You know, we rap about what we know.
Exactly.
We grew up knowing and everything. Yeah. And speaking of growing up knowing, is this what everybody knew that they was going to be doing at this time of their life? You know, here it is, putting in, you know, on a video, making y'all albums, you know, and everything. Is this what y'all knew that y'all was going to be doing at this point in your life? Or did y'all have, you know, different goals growing up, like what y'all wanted to be when y'all grew up or everything? Like what was that point that y'all knew y'all was going to be a rapper?
Man, I've been doing this, man, going on 17 years. Since I was 8 years old, I've been, like, putting bars together. I wrote a book in the third grade, so I always felt like I would be a writer. I always felt like I could articulate myself very well. And just growing up, my father, my big brother, a lot of people I know just did music, so I just kind of grew up in that. My mother, so it just kind of made me just, like, you know, and none of them are, like, trying to be famous with it. I think it was just the new generation and just like the generation I grew up in, just kind of made me in the where I grew up also, you know what I mean? Kind of gave me like, I guess the blessed me with the experiences to be able to articulate my talent the way
now
I
you, now you're really from Gary, right?
Yeah, I'm from Gary, Indiana. But I represent the fort. It ain't really where you from, it's where you at. And,
exactly.
You know, home is where the heart is. And I've been out here 4 years. I love this place. I love all the people that I've met out here. And I mean, if you know anything about my hometown, it's not really the place where something like this can happen. So I feel like, you know, like Nizzy said, God don't work for no reason. You know, I was brought here for a reason. I was given the talent and the opportunities and the connections that I had at the moment, and it just really came out special. So, but long story short, I really felt like I would be doing this. Honestly, optimistically, I felt like I would be doing a lot more than this at this point. But definitely. Definitely felt like I would be at this point in my life.
So 20 artists, it was normally 20 artists on the track?
Yeah.
Man, and having all them people there, man, it's just, I know it just had to be movement for y'all, man. Just seeing everybody there and seeing different people, meeting different people for the first time. Have any of y'all worked with any of the other artists that's not here right now before? Or, you know, those other local artists that's not here with us today, but, you know, y'all knew each other outside of this project, right?
Yeah, we've all heard of each other, I believe. Haven't got a chance to work with a lot of the artists. I worked with the producer, Chad Deutsch, on my last project I did last year. And actually, me and Chrome Cats are in the process of hitting the studio, so we got something as of now, but no, not prior to the... So I actually think that it was good that it came together, because I actually got like three collaborations out of this project. So I think it was a good thing to bring everybody together and be like, yo, you know, work with these, you know.
For Chromecast, y'all working on your album coming out right now, right?
Flight to Paradise.
Flight to Paradise. Tell us about that. What's Flight to Paradise all about?
Well, we really we started working on that album about
2 years ago,
I think. But we started really recording stuff for it about last summer and stuff. And so far, I think we've recorded about like 18 songs for it. But right now we're just really working on the edits of it and everything and just getting it right.
Now this is a brother sister combo right here, ain't it? Which one's older? Who's the oldest?
I'm older. I'm 17.
Oldest. Oh, so you gotta look up to him. So did you see your brother rapping that made you want to start off rapping and everything like that?
I don't really rap. I sing.
Well, yeah. But you getting into the music and everything, seeing him rapping just got you involved into the whole.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, we started when we're it was my mom's idea when we were 11. When I was 11 and she was 9 or 8, as a summer hobby,
my mom's idea was for us to kind of find something to do, and she came up with the idea for us to
do
music.
She wanted to get
music.
Y'all out of hair, right? Go play. Go make music. Oh, just go. I know how it is, but it's something that, you know, instead of being out, you know, running around the streets or everything, you know, get y'all involved in something.
Yep, so she came up with the idea for us to make music, and she, like, took us out to the first studio, and we kind of, like, made a couple songs, and then we just kept on going and kept on making music.
Okay. So Team Certified, you know, you guys are the well-known local artists here and everything. What started this off for y'all, you know, to get the group going? Y'all knew each other young? Y'all was little kids growing up, best friends growing up? Or how did Certified come about?
It's actually kind of crazy. You know, we used to do music on our own separately. I know for myself, I would hear about him being one of the best at his school at the time when we were in high school through some mutual friends that we both knew. And, you know, we really did our own thing, and we were great at it. And we ended up coincidentally running into each other in Florida. And, like, a couple people that knew both of us knew that we were good at rapping, you know, were like, you know, it's about time y'all finally met each other, so now we're finna get this rap battle going on. And they made us rap for 3 days straight.
3 days straight?
Days.
Just straight rapping.
Right? Yeah, out of nowhere, everywhere. Like, hey, go ahead and rap about something real quick. And we're like, man, come on. Like,
put it down, though, right? You had to show them, right? Y'all showed them who won. It was like a tie. It was a tie?
Yeah, because, you know, we're known for, you know, kind of dominating all of our matchups that we've been in.
It's about time to end it. Y'all just had to have that respect for each other, man.
Y'all to work together. It was magic. You know, usually you battle somebody, you just rip them to shreds, you know.
What type of stuff was they throwing out there at y'all? Was it some crazy off-the-wall things that y'all had to spit on? Or?
I mean, it was just random times. Like, it was just out the blue, you know. It could be walking to the basketball court. So, hey, spit something. And hey, spit something. You know what I'm saying? We get to going and, oh, I don't know. You know, we got similar styles, but we different. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
You know, that's what makes
that's
it
what
like.
That's what makes up a group. Yeah, you know, different styles.
Yeah. Shout out to B King too. He's not.
Yeah,
here,
shout out to B King. Everybody. Shout out to all the artists that's not even here, man. Yeah, about the artists, was other artists on the track and everything. Was it a certain group that kind of certain artists that stood out to you guys that's not here with us right now? Was it somebody y'all want to give a shout out to? Like I know my cousin. Cousins Price, PMG, he was on a track with you guys and everything. Who else was on a track with you guys?
SWAT Boys.
SWAT Boys.
SB.
James Chrome Hearts.
Shouts out to all the other artists that's not here with us right
cheese.
Now.
Yeah, definitely. Mo Cheese. Can't forget about Mo Cheese. He was one of the first on BET from the city.
Yeah,
you know,
man.
What I'm saying? That's great. You know, that's inspiration for everybody.
And even from the you know, the cut list. I don't know all the artists, but I know Tubbs was on there. I like this verse. Yeah, I like Alibi. I represent
Alibi.
Teleport on the track. Man, that was ill. Oh, so yeah, man, ill verses got cut, man. But you know, it's time constraints and whatnot.
You know, with him saying that they got cut, there actually is an extended version. I don't know when the show will air, but the extended version we're going to release in 5 days that has all 20 artists. It's going to be on iTunes.
They're going to be on able to download on iTunes.
Download for free or iTunes if you want to support the artist. Mm-hmm.
That's good. That's real good. So, let me ask y'all, after, you know, people seeing the videos and, you know, hearing your music, what's it like, the fan base type? What is the fan base like with y'all? Like how does it feel knowing, having people come up to you guys, like, hey, you know, I seen you on the video, I heard you on the radio. How does that make y'all feel, you know, something that y'all put together and now you see other people coming together, coming to y'all, giving y'all props on things like that? You know, how does that make y'all feel on the inside with things like that? How does that make y'all feel?
It feels good. It feels like you're really getting out there and you're getting your work out there and people are seeing it. And it's a really good feeling.
Mm-hmm. You get a couple autographs already?
John
Hancock already? Like, oh, Zell, you got
at my driver's ed class. I actually just finished driver's ed.
Woo!
Turn up the radio like you know it's me, right?
you know, like that.
Yeah, they had me rapping for them and everything. So it was like, it was definitely different.
There's some footage we're releasing everywhere we go. We try and do behind the scenes footage, and we're taking the artists to the schools. Depending on which school it is, we pick a few artists, we take them out there and they talk. And to see these kids, they're running up to them and giving them hugs, and they're signing autographs. So I don't know what your fan base was like before this, but I'm definitely seeing the artists now have real established fans, and they're getting tweets, and they're signing autographs and hugs, and girls are screaming for them. So it's cool to see, like, locally, these guys are celebrities now.
Yeah, yeah.
And if, you know, I encourage them to keep working together.
Yeah. Do all y'all plan on working with some of the artists again on any future projects or anything like that? Y'all have anything coming up that with other artists that y'all working together?
Definitely, man. Yeah. I think everybody respects everybody, especially, you know, on this project. And, you know, just kind of going back to, you know, God, you know, works in mysterious ways. Like, you know, I never really got the chance to work with everybody that's on the song, but mm-hmm. all in one motion, in one swoop. But now I worked with almost everybody.
Y'all just had a performance down at the Scottish Rite. Is that right? Mm-hmm. I had a performance. How did that go? How did that turn out? How was that?
I mean, it was what it was. I mean, the event wasn't as big as I thought it was gonna be, personally. I mean, but we came out there, we did what we had to do. There was a few artists that couldn't make it, but you know, Alex filled in.
Yeah, you know, that's what I was gonna be my next thing I brought up, Alex. I saw you on the mic, man. I didn't know you spit like that, yeah. Boy.
I actually don't rap, but these guys kind of convinced me to go up there and fill in for Troy's verse, which I've heard a lot about his verse. People like it because he says Indiana.
Yeah,
I see people doing
it. It's a well-known verse that hooks to one.
There's a few verses. I feel like all of them stick in your mind, but everybody that I talk to is like, I was born in Indiana. Yeah. So I knew the verse, and they were like, just fill in for him.
That was crazy. When I seen it, man, I just bust out laughing, yeah. Man. I was like, look at Alex up there doing his thing. Right. Boy, you looked right.
Well, I might come out with an album soon.
You always got to put a twist in there, man. You know.
Yeah, you always got to do something sure. to throw in there and everything.
Sure.
Well, so I seen all the artists on stage. You know, everybody looked like they was having a good time and everything, man. And then how did the release party go? I wasn't able to make it to the release party, the release of the video for the My City video. Was that nice?
It was like a full capacity basically, and everybody was participating with it. So
yeah.
It was a nice little energy.
That's what I meant. Like I was outside with him. Couldn't get in though, but you know, I was in it. I was out there. I was in the crowd outside. So I can imagine what it was like inside, boy. But with that night though, man, because when I was going to it and I pulled up on the street and I just said, man, like I said, just seeing something, all of y'all come together and seeing something like this, and all these people here to support, you know, it's a beautiful thing and everything. And so, like, how did that night go? Did it start off with y'all showing? Y'all showed the video right off top, or how did that go? Like.
They did like they went around and gave everybody like a 3-minute segment to just go up there. Some people spit, some people did a song, some people just like asked a couple questions just to kind of get everybody in the crowd familiar with the artist. And then at midnight is when they dropped the video.
Yeah. And everybody's like, yeah, that's me up there. It's a child been waiting on. It's a child been seeing.
The biggest thing that tripped me out is to see like when everybody's segment of the song came up and everybody started clapping. And, you know, screaming for, you know, whether they knew that certain person or whether they just liked that person's verse or whatever they did on the song. Like, but to hear cheers for each individual person, that really, you know, put a good feeling inside of me just to know that people respect what we're doing.
How long did it take to complete this project? It
took 8 months. I approached Certified July of last year.
8 months.
Yeah, and it's still going. So hiphopforthecity.com, the number 4, is where you go to keep updated on it, because they're going to perform for the mayor. Mm-hmm. There's 3 or 4 other performances coming up, so it's still going, 8 months and continuing.
Now for the video, how long did it take to put the video together, piece everything together, and with all the engineering and everything that tried to do with it? And
yeah, it took 3 weekends. Behind the scenes, obviously, we did a little more. Better Fort helped coordinate it with Lynchpin Creative, but the shoot was 3 weeks. 3 weekends, sorry.
3 weekends. Mm-hmm. How did it feel being on top in the tin caps? We saw you on Parkview Field, you know, saw you on Parkview Field and everything. And, you know, Parkview Field was just built you know, just was just built. So, you know, that gave everybody a shot to see exactly who hasn't been to a 10 Caps game, which really you should be going to see because it's very amazing. It gave everybody a chance to really, you know, look at basically the video gave people who never been to Fort Wayne or anything mm-hmm. a chance to see exactly what Fort Wayne had to offer and everything. And being in certain locations that I seen, like, you know, seeing seeing 2RQ on the bridge, mm-hmm. you know, I thought that was a nice shot, sure. seeing them on the bridge and everything. And like I said, seeing Price come around on that wall,
Hyde Bookstore.
Yeah, because, you know, them are things people normally, like, you know, when you come around Fort Wayne, you see these things. It's like, you know, some spots people didn't even know was there. That's right. Another thing. You know, that's the whole point of this whole thing. Mm-hmm. Like, it's a lot of things that you can do here. A lot of things that's here that people don't know about. And, you know, y'all coming together doing this is really what's letting them know, you know, what's going on and everything. So, definitely. I mean, that's really good that what y'all doing and everything. So what is it, Alex, the next step from here? What other projects do you think can come out of this? This is like the opening of the door right here, you know?
Right.
Like, what's some plans that you plan? What was your main goal you want to see come out of this?
Right, well, personally, I love music, and I'd love to help these guys continue working together. Unfortunately, at Better Fort, we're not a music organization. Mm-hmm. So, you know, sending this project off, we'll look back and say that was a great project. We got 20, 30 new volunteers. We're getting people more involved in the community. But a Better Fort's going to continue doing what they do best, and that's get young adults connected, get them involved in the community. I do encourage all you guys, keep working together. I want to see a mixtape. I want to see a couple collaborative albums.
And I'm going to be on the mixtape. I'm going to be right there with you guys. Mm-hmm. You know, don't forget Cool Cat on the mixtape, people. Yeah, I can spit.
I wasn't planning, though, about that album skit, though.
Oh, most definitely. Shout out to my BCC family out there and everything, you know, Black Crazy Comedians and everything. Right. But Certified, so what's next for Certified? What, y'all got some mixtapes going on, or what's next?
We got Certified Business. That's on datpiff.com right now. Just type Certified, go to datpiff and just type it in. You can Google us, everything will come up. I mean, we ain't hard to find, you know.
So you got clothing?
We got clothing, Grind Hard. That's who we working with our clothing. That's Mo Cheese. He runs all that stuff for us, so it's definitely been a good year for us.
Yeah, definitely.
Gary, Indiana, what you have working on? What you working on now? What?
Right now, I'm in the midst of like two different projects right now. We finishing up an EP called Back to Hip Hop, which is just my tribute to just bringing back the true essence of what we know as hip hop. Just going back to the spitting, back to the beats, you know, not getting away from, just kind of getting away from all the dancing and snappy, cracky, poppy stuff. You know what I mean? Like, it's just time to get back to hip hop. People want to hear people spitting. It's a time for the club joint. I mean, when you at the club. But a lot of people that listen to hip hop are kind of like getting tired of the same old same. So they kind of want to just go back to just the essence. I just want to hear somebody spitting.
Yeah, you know, like, and that's kind of what. One of my other favorite verses on the song is 2RQ's, you know, you got blacks on blacks, you know, he's like locked up, and you know, just hearing his verse, man, it had me, you know, it had you thinking, like, that's how lyrically deep he is. I knew 2RQ from down to CS3, he performs down to CS3 and everything, and you know, I always known him as being one of the lyricists that I knew, you know, the real deep lyricists and everything like that. But you know, when all y'all came together, was it a time that all y'all was in just one room, all y'all was just right there, like all the artists, is like, you know, was it ever a time that most of y'all was together, was it somebody that stood out that you like, man, I can't wait to hear him, or I can't wait to?
I mean, when I did the hook, so I didn't even really even put a verse on the song, so it was kind of, you know, amazing for me to just sit back and see, like, okay, what they gonna do, you know, because my part was already laid down. You know what I'm saying?
And what that they about to bring to the table.
Yeah, I'm like, okay, what's going to be said on this, you know? And everybody, like I said, I salute everybody on the song. Everybody had great verses on the video and the extended version. Everybody, you know, held their own ground. And like I said, Fort Wayne has talent here, you know, period.
So, Troy, I mean, so what did you get out of this whole project of the video, My City video, and now that you know, for the better for what they brought to the table? Like, what did you get out of this? Because, you know, anything that people bring is a learning experience. Yeah. Anything that's new to you is a learning experience. Is, you know, all knowledge is good knowledge, you know. So is it something that you still felt you've grown from
yeah, like, participating? Because I'm still, like, I'm, I don't say I'm new, but I just started getting more serious with music maybe like a year or two ago. So I got a lot of exposure, a little more exposure for this, I would say, because everybody would be like, yeah, man, I know you was on that song. Like, yeah. Like, oh, hey, man, you kind of nice. So, I mean,
you should have known. Yeah, I feel you. Like, oh, you ain't know?
Like, I mean, but, like, I don't really, like, but me just kind of getting serious with it, I don't have, like, a team or anything. Like, I'm still getting established and, like, trying to get stuff together. So, like, that radio play, like, that was big for me. Like, I didn't take that for granted because, I mean, a lot of people, especially from around here, like, try to get on the radio because they think it's easy, but it's not that
easy.
Yeah, so, I mean, to get your song on the radio, that's huge, so.
And then what's crazy, a crazy story. I was just at the store the other day, and, like, soon as I walked in the store, the song was on, going right into my verse. Literally, I walked up to the glass. Yeah, I was like, that's me right there. She was like, for real? Did she stop for a second? It's like, ah! And then I just start spitting it. So, yeah, that radio is definitely, yeah, man. Everybody
on the side. Then you after that, like, then she was on you after that. Was, you didn't even have to pay, did you? She said, go on, boy. You know, money ain't no good.
Go ahead, here. Take that.
But, and that's another thing. You know, clickhop.com, you know, they, you know, promoted pretty good for you guys and everything. Shouts out to them because they pushed it. They're hearing it on the radio every day, man.
They've been great working with us. You know, ClickHop definitely reached out. We actually all had a meeting with ClickHop to talk about stuff. You know, they reached out. They definitely reaching out. You know, Jay Hall, Ice, all them Nugget. You know, they showing support, man. That's what the city needs. You know,
yeah, that's all. That's really what it is, man.
The beautiful thing about it is. It's not just them playing the song, like, people are actually voting for it.
Voting, that's right. Because that was another thing, because, you know, with me, you know, going to work, you know, as soon as I get in the car, it's on. As soon as I get in the car after work, it's on, you know.
You almost can't people have a are trip actually without voting. Hearing
yeah.
it once.
Yeah. People are actually voting for you guys' song, man. That's really good. That makes me feel good for you guys, you know. People are really showing you guys support and everything, so.
You can touch it. He was checking somebody out in the group, wasn't he? He was checking somebody out, wasn't he? I know your mama and them over there. He ain't got to be scared. I'll just play with you.
Everybody, man, get a shot of her hair real quick, man. When she came in here, she was so worried about her hair, man. It looks perfect. It looks perfect, baby. Don't worry.
You got somebody in there.
Yeah, man. I want to thank everybody for, you know, coming out and everything. I want to thank everybody for tuning in and getting to see. You know, this is an opportunity to you guys to come in and meet everybody and get a better idea of the Better Fort Project or the Hip Hop for the City Project and everything. And if you haven't seen the video, go on YouTube, download it on iTunes, the song on iTunes. Figure it out, man, and get it. Basically, that's what I'm saying, man. Go ahead and get it.
Follow all of us.
All of everybody. Support all the local artists, everything over here, man. I want to thank everybody for coming out. Alex, Certified.
Crumcats.
No, I thought y'all was going to say it when I did it. Y'all ain't catch on. Us. Yeah, I thought I wanted y'all to throw it up there, but y'all ain't do it. It's all right, though, man. But I want to thank everybody for coming out, man. And, you know, keep on doing what y'all doing. You know, putting Fort Wayne on the map and everything. Y'all doing a good job, man. So, thank y'all for coming in, taking this time out and everything. And thank all y'all for tuning in. And that's a wrap.
This is my city, where I'm from. Talking about change, well, I want some. Just a group of kids trying to get it on. But we gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on. City on, city on, city on. We gon' be the ones to put the city on.
I could be anywhere, but I'm right here. Right now, I'm living life right now.
Yo, do your homework, PMG represent. Folk can't sweat.